Hey everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome back to Sproggiwood. This time we're going to the big tree to negotiate a truce or peace pact or whatever, and we're going to be playing. I like it that the thief kind of looks like Altair from Assassin's Creed. I don't think that was unintentional. Anyway, we are going with this, and we want to use the Ghost Brand of the Wisp King. Awesome, let's go in. Should probably buy a health potion at some point too. Oh well, doesn't matter that much. I like stabbings. Especially because we actually heal as we stab, which is very much appreciated. First, let's level up, get cleave, and cleave the crap out of everything, and win. Unfortunately, I'm going to have to go over the poison just to get through. Whatever, doesn't matter that much, because I can just cleave my way to victory. Doink! Oh, crap. Watch out for that. Good to know. Red slimes explode. And we're going to go with shield wall, just in case. We run into something dangerous. Because there's always something dangerous. Yay, there we go. Not falling prey to dangerous things again. Oh, ow. I'll be fine. Honestly, we're actually pretty close to full health anyway. So it doesn't matter that much. Let's just cleave, cleave, and cleave again. Honestly, I'm enjoying the warrior class. I feel like... Ow. Could have avoided that better. Oh well, doesn't matter that much. Doink. I'm a little bit disappointed that cleave does not break pots. Oh well, it does not actually matter that much, and the cash reward for these areas seems to be pretty substantial. So, haste potion. As long as you only move or wait, enemies do not act for 30 turns. I'm keeping that. Goodbye, invisibility potion. You were nice, but not nearly as awesome as haste. Of course, realistically, I should probably use the haste potion. I'm not even sure if I used the haste potion the last time. Oh, hey, the explosions actually harm. Everything exploded there. I had no way of avoiding that. Oh well, male vitality, that boosts our health up, and I mean, we've got our own internal healing ability anyway. So, our sort of internal, sort of external, sort of stabbing-based healing ability. I'm okay with this. And level up, perfect. I'm gonna get cleave. Because cleave is incredibly effective at killing everything. And I love it so much. Okay, let's just wait here and then stab the crap out of everything. Okay. So, we're making very good time. Ow. Note to self, fight those guys preferably when you can dodge them. Oh, doesn't matter that much. We're actually pretty close to full health. And that shrine was useless. Oh well. Not like it matters that much. We've actually got 1,000 gold too, and we can head for an exit because we're actually done. Probably could have gone for the other exit. Hey, there's a healing shrine. 3 health. Totally needed that. Totally. So I think what I'm going to do as far as this game, and if it seems a little bit easy to you, that's because I am actually playing it on the easier difficulty. There is hard mode, can't be selected from campaign mode. I'm going to cash this in, but the thing is, you can actually select hard mode from the map. But I'm actually going to do a second run-through of this game in hard mode at a later date. Boink. Boink. They'll explode. Wow. Everything still explodes all over the place. Joy of loot. Awesome. Stormguard vest. I forgot to equip it. No, wait. I might actually be wearing it. I don't know. Nope. What equipment? I am wearing it. What does it do? 10 HP whenever you attack. Chance to shoot out 4 bolts of lightning and jump to... Oh, that's awesome. I'm keeping that. Okay, there we go. That's what I was trying to do. For whatever reason, I thought Q used my ability for a second there. And I was like, I don't know. There we go. Beautiful. Let's just keep stabbing everything. Guess I'll just... Everything explodes. Note to self, get out of the way the next time that happens. Not like it matters much. Seriously. I am a true champion. Among heroes. Everything's going to explode here, and I'm not entirely appreciative of it, but that's okay, because pretty much no matter what, I can win. Seriously, the way the ability mechanics work in this game are awesome. Anyway, as I was saying, I'm probably going to do a full run-through of this game on easy, and then I'm going to do a full run-through of this game on hard. And then I don't know, kind of depending on the variety of this game, I might actually stop the series just because... No, I'm keeping the Stormguard vest. It is too awesome to be gotten rid of. In favor of, you know, vitality. But at that point, I'll probably stop the game and maybe come back to it later. But at the same time, by the point that I've Done. Well, everything explodes, as always. Do avoid that. But, you know, by the point that I've pretty much cleared the entire game in full, both in regular and hard mode, I'm gonna sell the health potion. I don't think I'm gonna need it. Haste potion is going to be far more effective at taking out the final boss than a health potion ever will be. Oh, this dungeon might actually be a bit longer. Normally, by this point, I've run into... Ow. I would have been safe where I was. Oh, hey, that's the Stormguard vest, and that's a different type of slime. They seem to leave interesting ooze puddles. I have to try it. Oh, hey. They're not actually threatening. Jeez, there's all sorts of stuff going on here. I'll just keep avoiding it, keep stabbing. Seriously, everything just results in stabbing anyway. Might as well just stab. Joy of loot, and yes. Oh, interesting. So if you don't walk over those, they actually spawn into new cubes. Oh, that's terrifying. Well, I guess we know what must be done. Stab, stab, and stab some more. Jeez. How do I get rid of these slimes? Keep Stormguard vest. Well, I'm getting rid of them somehow. Jeez. Okay. So, yeah, you do, in fact, have to walk over them. Doink. Okay, finally took them out. That took a lot of effort. Probably should have used Dervish, come to think of it, instead of Cleave. Oh, well, doesn't matter that much. Because we found a Vitality Shrine right off the bat. I'm gonna go this way. Oh. Well. Guard! Hey, it works. Okay, let's use that. Probably could have waited with that, come to think of it. Oh, well. Too late. Doesn't matter that much. And yes, explosions. The explosions don't harm me. For I can use cover mechanics like a champion. Like a true champion. And dodge. There we go, dodge. Okay, so we have to worry about the big guy spawning the little cubes. Oh, well, there's not gonna... Oh, hey. By moving down, I managed to lure away the other one. I'm actually going to want to escape this direction, probably. There. And this way the fire doesn't harm me. Yeah, definitely should have kept the healing potion for later. Well, it doesn't matter that much. Let's use the haste potion. Not like it matters much. Probably could have sold it, actually, and done just about as well. Not even sure. Oh, the effects are over there. Oh, interesting. And we get another healing shrine, so we got that going for us, which is awesome. Well, let's just murder the crap out of this guy. And dodge? Unfortunately, I can't move diagonally. Well, shields. It works. Let's just keep with the casual murder. And I should be safe if I... Damn it. Oh, well, it doesn't matter that much because we only have, like, one chamber left to go through. And then we got the healing shrine, so it's not going to matter that much. But, yeah, I think I will only ever do... one playthrough of this game. And that'll probably be... Oh. Interesting. So, even if you don't see it, the slime puddles are still there. Okay, so I'm gonna have to be a little bit careful about that. Okay, and they stack on each other too, so if there are multiple, you have to go over them twice. Huh. Well, that's actually a very threatening enemy, and I'm honestly kind of impressed with it. Okay, so I can't do cleave. I maxed out cleave. Well, let's just do shield wall. It's probably for the best. Let's go here for the healing shrine, because, well, I like being full health. Oh, it's not actually full health either. Oh, maybe getting that one healing shrine actually didn't matter. Okay, Chamber of the Council. Are all of these leaves going to be mushroom people? If that's the case, I'm actually going to be totally okay with it. Because they're very easy to handle. Honestly, just have to just keep cleaving. There's probably a boss somewhere along the way, but I don't know, thus far. Okay, gonna cash it. Unless we run into something absolutely terrifying, we should be fine, and I can use the haste potion if we run into a really hard enemy, because it's not like we're gonna lose any health against the mushroom people, at least as far as they stand right now. Oh, are these, okay. I'm going to wager that that's their king. Well, in that case, let's use the haste potion. Ah, Mushroom Elder 1. The Clogheads are most destructive indeed. I've already put down gentle Big Ick, and they pillaged the Goatress's warrens. If left unchecked, they'll wreak havoc on our society. Yip yip, we must think of the mushrooms first. Yip yip, the clogheads must go. Please, siblings, hear me. I've visited with the clogheads. I've broken bread in their homes. You misunderstand the nature of their actions. They're simple, peace-loving people. They value order and community above all else, and they mean us no harm. Consider how bountiful a friendship with the clogheads might be. Can we not put aside our perceived differences and unite under one common goal? Look, a cloghead. One has come to plead the case of our people. Of its people. Pay attention to how cute and peaceful it looks. It's sort of cute. Yep, yep. And peaceful looking. Yes, yes. Come, gentle cloghead. Enter our home. Meet my siblings, my wonderful mushroom brethren. Sproggy mushroom costumes falls off. Sproggy. Sproggy mushroom elder one. Why this villainy? Yip yip, it's a cloghead plot. How devious. Yip yip. That's it. That is all. Let us declare war on the clogheads. Yip yip. Let us declare war. Unleash the Hulk Shroom. Sweet Jesus. Well, I pretty much have carp. What? But I got. Oh, he can't move. But he can still attack me. Well, that just. I didn't put any points into charge. Here's what I'm gonna do. Shields up. So I don't take any damage from it. Ah, well. Close enough. Managed to. So next time, go with a healing potion. And read the door. Does it give me any cash? The answer is no. But there's. I mean, there's some mysterious area over on the right that I can't reach. Not entirely sure how that works. Oh, well. Let's go through. And we get 1,000 gold and another spider. Seriously, spiders? I hate spiders. Well, that did not go as planned. Quest complete. Plead the Cloghead case. Council of Big Tree. I should have used a professional tailor for my mushroom disguise. Now the mushrooms are convinced that the whole fiasco is a Cloghead plot. It will not be reasoned with. How upsetting. On the plus side, you did salvage this chest from the chamber of the council. I suggest returning it, but the mushrooms would probably kill you. Might as well open it up. Sweet loot! And I guess we can unlock the archer. Oh, your village is so lovely. So civilized. I hope beyond hope that mushrooms don't burn it down. I must think on how to appease them. By Racco, I must devise the plan. I will return, Cloghead. For now, savor the comforts of civilization. Then come find me. Alright, time to talk to Slav again. Sproggy was acting awfully bizarre, wasn't he? Who's this? Wait, we've already seen this. No! No! Well, can I? Okay, I can just, like, turbo my way through it. Can't press escape or anything like that. Well, oh wait. Spacebar brings us straight through. Okay, so note to self, never talk to the slime again. It's a trap. Okay, next up. Could get the shovel. Tempted to get the shovel. Getting the shovel. And then, let's, Oh, I haven't unlocked any other gear for them. Well, doesn't matter that much, and unfortunately I can't buy anything else, but I do want to get a Stormguard vest because it's pretty damn awesome. And might as well get the Dungarees of Vitality. Yeah. Not like Frostbarb Sword, why not? I'll just spend all of the money on all of the things, and I'll save the rest. Should probably actually put points into the Academy Expansion Apothecary Fund. Oh, yeah, should definitely put a bunch of points into the Merchant Quarter, come to think of it, instead of just buying items willy-nilly. Really, I should finish the Civic Boost before I go on to anything else. So, I will do that. Anyway, let's go to the map. Don't want to talk to him. Oh, no, no, no. Cloghead, come quick. Something awful has happened. The mushroom civilization is expanding so quickly. They're multiplying, evolving. They've spread beyond Sproggiwood and into Ghostfen. Ghostfen is a scary place filled with hungry, bloated frogs and creepy spiders. But that's not all. Even greater danger lurks in the waters of the Fen. They aren't ready. They have no idea. Look, I know the clogheads and the mushrooms are not on the best of terms. Yes, they were furious when they discovered our plot at the Big Tree. Yes, they declared war on your people. But they're in grave danger. You must help them. You are their only hope. You must journey into the heart of the Ghost Fen. The way in lies through the bloated grotto, where the giant frog Romako makes his lair. Go there, and best Romako. Carve a path into the fen before it's too late. Alright, time to go stab a frog, but my face hurts, which probably means I've been talking too long, which probably means I'm at the end of the episode. So, I will see you guys on the next episode of Sproggiwood. And as always, thanks for watching. because I enjoy stabbing everything for the joy of the internet or something like that. Anyway, like I was saying, see you guys next time.